King Charles has received a welcome to remember in the nation's capital, being sneezed on by an alpaca and yelled at by an angry senator. Overall, the crowds were big and enthusiastic, with many getting their chance to meet the monarch.
The King in the capital. At the front of Parliament House, fronting the troops to take the salute as a 21-gun variety was fired in his honour. Day four of his whistle-stop tour, and in Canberra, controversy after reviewing the troops outside. King Charles and Queen Camilla, guests of honour at a formal parliamentary reception, welcomed with both an Indigenous arrivals ceremony and national anthem rendition. The King's speech and offer of gratitude and thanks.
In my many visits to Australia, I have witnessed the courage and hope that have guided the nation's long and sometimes difficult journey towards reconciliation.
But the moment he finished, controversial Senator Lidia Thorpe began. The crossbench senator's outburst infuriating many. She shouted Charles was not her king. The King and Queen appeared calm as security led her out of the Great Hall, leaving Their Majesties to meet and greet a gathering of great Australians. Legend Olympian Jess Fox, adventurer Dick Smith, former Governor General Peter Cosgrove, all honoured to meet Their Majesties. But it was nothing like the reception they'd get from the public crowds today. This was the scene as they arrived at the Australian War Memorial. For some, it was almost religious.
Oh, no, but we did come
out! Are you okay?
That was so exciting!
Inside the memorial, more sombre moments as Their Majesties laid wreaths, flowers, and paused to remember the sacrifice of Australia's armed forces. They also walked along the roll of honour and of the 103,000 fallen, choosing two to place a poppy beside. First World War soldiers William James Johnson and William Punch. Yeah. Outside, the memorial roads were packed, around 4,000 people and one alpaca. This is Hefner, and there's theories he's a Republican. Hefner had just sneezed on the King.
So he doesn't have great royal manners.
No, for sure, but look, as they say, never work with children and animals.
At least he was dressed respectfully.
Hefner is wearing a bow tie, he's wearing a little jacket here, and he's also got a crown.
As for King Charles, he didn't seem to mind.
It sneezed on me.
I've got the shot.
I was in Nepal years ago, an elephant sneezed on me. That's not a good idea.
The rest of the crowd, far more polite.
Long live the King!
Through ever-present phones, the royal superfans chanted.
I got to shake his hand. It was a dream come true, dream come true.
So you shook his hand? How did that feel?
Hand. Incredible. Never washing it.
In total, King Charles carried out 10 separate engagements today, plus these public meet and greets. The British media say this is today by far the most intense and demanding schedule since his cancer diagnosis in February.
Everywhere he went, the 75-year-old in constant high spirits.
Nice and sunny for you. Bit hot?
It's sunnier than Sydney.
Not like yesterday at their harbourside home, where the royal couple had enjoyed the Sydney sunshine at the end of the day, like any normal tourists, sunbaking, relaxing, taking in the majesty of an Australian spring day.
And we have reporters standing by covering the royals. First to Chris Reason in Canberra. Chris, where are the King and Queen now?
Good evening to you, Peter. Well, now at Canberra Airport, getting ready to head back to Sydney after what has been a very busy day for the couple, which also included official meetings with the Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese, the opposition leader, Peter Dutton, also climate change talks at the Botanic Gardens and planting of trees as well. And after being spat at by an alpaca and shouted at by Lidia Thorpe, they're probably looking forward to getting back to that pool at Admiralty House, Pete.
Chris Reason in Canberra, thank you. Now to political editor Mark Riley. And Mark, what do you make of the commotion up there in Canberra?
Well, Mitch, I think most Australians will see Lidia Thorpe's actions for what they were: rude, disrespectful, grandstanding. There was a sense she was going to pull on a stunt when she appeared in a possum skin coat. It was, for her, all about attracting attention to her black sovereign movement, relaxed in the knowledge that no action will be taken against her. But it was just one sour note on an otherwise bright day for the Parliament. A shining moment in Parliament's marble foyer, signing the visitor's book in the building his mother opened in 1988. In the Great Hall, a collection of great Australians from politics, sport, the arts and business.
Since your first visit in 1966, you have been taken into Australian hearts, just as you have taken us into yours.
The King responding with a gift, giving the government's cost of living policies royal approval.
Australia's economic growth has been remarkable.
Praising Australia's growth as a multicultural society, but noting the big continuing challenge.
I have witnessed the courage and hope that have guided the nation's long and sometimes difficult journey towards reconciliation.
How difficult? Soon obvious. Independent Senator Lidia Thorpe, wearing a possum skin coat, insistent, insulting. She'd been moved on earlier from the war memorial, continuing her protest outside Parliament.
We don't need a king from another country to dictate to us what we do here.
Despite the disturbance inside, the Republicans' hopes that this visit might add new momentum to their movement have largely failed. The overwhelming sentiment here is one of goodwill towards the monarch. Opposition leader Peter Dutton making a dry observation.
People have had haircuts, people have shined shoes, suits have been pressed, and that's just the Republicans.
As the Republic movement courts controversy, calling it a farewell tour.
It is bad taste, particularly given the King's ill health. It's more or less saying, we won't be seeing you again.
It's monarchy that we're farewelling. It's time to wave goodbye.
The only waves today, waves of adulation. Mark Riley, 7 News.